Hey traders, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going over my live trade here on GbpJpy. I just closed half the trade up 1R to book profits as our plan calls for. I now have half the trade running up 12 pips and we're gonna let this trade develop. In the video today, I'm going to break down everything that I liked about the trade. I'm going to explain to you why I took the position and how I plan on managing it going forward. But before we get into the recap here, I want to first say thank you. It's Thanksgiving, so I'm taking time today to think about the things that I'm most thankful for. And one of them, one of the top three, is you guys, my YouTube family, my Instagram family, the people that are giving me attention almost every day to learn and hopefully grow together. I am most appreciative for you guys. So thank you. Now, I want to also let you know that it is Thanksgiving, like I said, but that means tomorrow is Black Friday. So we've got a huge, huge announcement starting tomorrow. It's going to be a one-day sale only, and we're going to drop our new trader education bundle. In that bundle, you're going to get access to the beginner course and the VIP chat on Telegram and Facebook, and you're also going to get access to the Philly seminar replay. It's a 10-hour day, all of it recorded, and you're going to get the Philly seminar PDF study guide. So you get the study guide, the whole presentation I went over, and the full Philly seminar replay with the course and VIP chat. We're calling it the New Trader Education Bundle because this is the best place for a new trader to start. And on Black Friday, tomorrow, if you're seeing this on Thanksgiving, you're going to be able to get that New Trader Education Bundle for the first time on sale. After tomorrow, if you're watching this after Black Friday, the New Trader Education Bundle is still for sale. The link is in the description below, but tomorrow, Black Friday, is the big sale, so you don't want to miss that. Now, let's talk about this GbpJpy trade. As you can see, I'm up 11.6 pips. I was up about 14, 15, and that's when I took half the trade off because that was 1R, and that's what my plan calls for. If we go over to TradingView here, you can see this morning at about, let's see what time is that, 4 o'clock this morning, we broke out off the 50 EMA, off the 200 EMA. That was the original entry signal. I wasn't awake, well, I wasn't at my desk for that entry signal. It pulled back, but held the 8 EMA really well. And as it started to come back up off the 8, I liked what it was doing on the shorter timeframes, so I decided to take the position respecting the original entry idea, this two candle formation, and its stop loss. So I was in a little bit late, but I still liked the risk reward potential here, 35 pips to ADR, right? And I still used the original stop loss from the original entry. So people ask me all the time, if I'm late on an entry, but I can still get a good price, can I still take it? Yes, but you gotta use the original stop loss from the original trade idea. So it's almost like you were in, you just got a better price. So it actually works out a little bit better for me now. The reason I was long biased, how did I know to buy it here today? We had a good push up yesterday going from the London into New York. We caught this move during 9, 10 o'clock in the morning, and that kind of consolidated overnight. But what I really liked overnight was the break of the 200 EMA and the pins here to the 200 and the 50. I liked how the TDI also held the buy zone. We have a rising RSI from yesterday, which tells me strength is more likely than not moving higher. And then again, when we pushed off the 50 and off the 200 and broke for just barely, but broke for a new high of day and closed for a new high of day, that signals to me that we, at that point, can more likely than not see movement to the upside. Now, when we talk about measuring the risk reward of a setup like this, I know where I want my stop to be, about 15, 16 pips, and I know that my first area of slowing could probably be the first pivot point right here where we did slow down. But until this breaks the 8 EMA and even the 21 EMA, this could just be moving its way slowly because we know the market kind of breathes like in waves, right? It could be moving its way slowly up to max ADR, 83 pips. We have a little bit more than 20 pips left to still see this thing push on ADR, which was another reason that I felt confident to take the trade. On top of that, we were looking at the other GBP pairs. Now, GBP-NZD sometimes will move off on its own. It's very heavily weighted to the NZD. But if you look at GU, this was long biased, very clearly. Look at the TDI, look at the EMAs. You have the 800 EMA, the 200 EMA, the 50 EMA, all stacked in trend. You opened above the daily pivot point, so this is long biased. Even GCAD, some of the guys were looking at this to move higher today as well. So all these other GBP pairs telling me that we were going to move higher, I liked the entry the most on GJ, and I got paid on GJ because of the analysis and using correlated pairs to find the best possible setup. So now, it's 5:51, we're in the trade, as you guys saw, we are already closed. We've already closed half the position, and we're going to let the rest of the position, if I could speak, we're going to let the rest of the position continue to develop. If you guys have any questions on what I just explained so far, on the breakout, on how I came up with the direction, on how I measured the risk reward, drop a comment down below. I will answer you always. Look at all my other videos, everything. I answer everybody's comments. Drop a comment below. Let me know if you have any questions. I'll explain it in more detail, maybe in text. You might understand it a little bit better. So, it's It's 5:52. I'm up in the trade. Stop loss is still at original position. 50% still on. I'm looking to see if we can get this thing higher to ADR. 140.78, 140.80. We'll see how it handles there. If it ends up coming back down and breaking under the 8 EMA, breaking under the 21, I'm going to look to either take a small loss, right? Because even if I close down in here, let's say I'm down 7 pips, because I closed half the trade up 14, I'd still be profitable. Barely, but still be profitable. And that's what matters the most to me is win, 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 win. So we're holding the 8 EMA. Let's see if we can body this pivot and get up to ADR. I'll keep you guys posted as the trade develops. I appreciate you being here as always. Drop a comment if you have any questions, and I'll check back in a few minutes. All right, guys, it is almost 7 o'clock now. I'm still in the trade, haven't taken anything off since I last checked in with you guys. I've sat through and we're back up about 14 or 15 pips. I sat through what was a little bit of a slowdown period as it broke the 8 EMA, kind of retested the 21, and now it's pushing higher, looking like we might break the pivot point here, maybe even in the next 2 minutes. This retest right here, these two pins in the last two 15-minute bars, comes right to yesterday's high. Look at the price at yesterday's high, 140.47. Look at that, right back to that 140.47 level. That's the same level also that we had a little bit of consolidation at earlier this morning. So this is how the market moves in waves. You get a break, you get a retest. If it holds, you're going to see more movement in that original breakout direction. It's exactly what we're happening. What's happening here. This A1 system is different than the divergence entries that I look for, but they do go hand in hand. This A1 system is more often than not breakout trades. The D1, D2 divergence stuff, that's pullback entries. So you have breakout entries and pullback entries, two different ways to take a trade. Now, as you can see, we're getting a nice shove here. Like I said, hopefully bodying the pivot here before this candle closes at 7 a.m. It's about a minute away. On the 1 minute, I want to show you something since we're talking about divergence. So I was in the trade. We noticed the RSI set a high here at 509. Price action went a little bit higher here at 523. So with price action rising, but the RSI falling, that created a little bit of divergence for me. When the TDI on the 1 minute dropped into the sell zone here, that can get you nervous. But because I stayed focused on the 15 minute and we never broke back underneath the 21 EMA, I knew that it could still move higher. You have to stay focused on the 15 minute trend and not get caught up in short-term 1 minute potential exit signals. In fact, I then just waited because I knew it could hit the 200 EMA, the white line here, which is the same thing on the 15 minute as the 21 EMA. I knew it could hit there, you know, pause, and then move higher off of it. Look at how it made divergence off the bottom there. Rising RSI, falling price action. Exactly what I like to see to then trust the TDI to take this thing higher. So as we come to the 15 minute close here in 17 seconds, it looks like we're gonna body through the pivot point. This looks really good as it heads up higher and higher and higher, 140.72 almost now. Pushing towards that max ADR. There you go, 140.72.6. So let me pull up MetaTrader here and show you guys. As you can see, up 22 pips, almost 23 pips now. This is a great trade, over 1R. So this is a good close. You wanna let this thing sit for at least another 15 minutes and see how it continues to develop. So what I'm gonna do now at 7 o'clock is let it breathe. I'll come back on with you guys and check in a few minutes, but I wanted to show you why I stayed in the trade, why I held in, why the 1 minute was telling me maybe get out, but keeping focus on the 15 minute said, hold on, you've got a good trending trade. You wanna let it breathe and see if it'll push ADR. You've got another 10, 15, less than 15 pips to go on till max ADR. So we're gonna look to get out of this trade fairly soon, but we do wanna let it breathe. So what we're gonna do now, actually we'll do it right now while we're on camera, is move the stop loss up to break even since we're up over 1.5 R. Make sure we don't lose any money on this trade. I've already booked some at 15. I could take off a little bit more, but I don't want to. I wanna let it develop. So instead of closing the trade, move the stop up and let it breathe. So like I said, 7 o'clock here, up 23, 22 pips. I'll come back on in a little bit and check in with you guys as the trade finishes out. All right, guys, it is 8:08. As you can see, the trade is bumping now. I'm up 36, 37, 38, 39 pips in this trade as it's starting to really get some volatility here. Notice ADR is maxed out now, so we're seeing more movement than on a typical day, more movement than on an average day. If we flip over really quick to where I had my take profit set here on TradingView, you can see it's smashing through that ADR line, looking like it's headed up here towards the next pivot. And that's typically what you'll see after it bodies through a pivot as it did here, retests it, it more likely than not will eventually make its way up to the next pivot. But since we are up very nice in this trade, I'm gonna close the whole thing right here. We are up over 2R. I'm now full out of the trade right there. As you can see, trade is closed. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. You can check the top right hand corner of the screen and you can see that's how it's done. So here again, just going over the trade, I saw the breakout, I saw a great entry price, I saw a great risk reward, taking it to the pivot first, took a little bit off there in the first initial pop, held in as it did not break the 8 and the 21, closed full trade here as we pushed to max ADR. That's following a system, that's following your rules, and that's how it should be done every day. So, like I told you guys at the beginning of the video, happy Thanksgiving. I hope you enjoy your day with your family. I hope you learned something here. Maybe you shared this video with your family instead of watching football. Maybe you guys were watching this. And if you're seeing it before Black Friday, the new Trader Education Bundle with our course and the seminar replay goes on sale tomorrow. If you're watching this after Black Friday, the information on how you can get that, how you can learn how to take entries just like this, the information is in the link in the description, okay? Have a great rest of your day. Have a great rest of your holiday, everybody, and I'll catch you in the next trading recap.